I've kind of got a music and a dance background and a few things that are probably my involvement in the arts was not the tough guy, you know, originally, you know, like I was in, you know, I wrote music, piano music, you know, and did ballet and dance, you know, and these softer expressions are kind of like part of my character. But I do think I flush them out in characters, but I sort of end up using them as secondary layers that help develop the character in the audience's mind, you know, like Crixus, you know. I came on so hard with Crixus that my director walked up to me, sorry, the producer of our show, Spartacus, walked up and said, Manu, what are you doing with Crixus? Nobody likes him. He's like so arrogant and unlikable. And I was like, I know, just trust me. Because, you know, it's And the reason I played it like that was because, you know, the reason I got into acting in the first place was, you know, I lost my mother and brother in two separate car accidents. And I was in the accident with my mother, and I was in a coma for like 2 weeks in a hospital. And when I woke up, you know, there were, you know, my worst enemy, the guy who was my worst enemy was at the hospital, you know, come to see me. And, you know, he'd lost his mother when he was younger and related to this moment that I was having. So even though he was my worst enemy, he came to me because of common circumstance. And all of a sudden, him and me formed a bond and became best friends. Now, that's what I infused into Crixus and Spartacus. When I saw how that story was going to flesh out, I went, I know this story already. But it doesn't start off pretty. It starts off as enemies. And it starts off with one of the characters. If one of them's playing the protagonist on the screen, then one of them has to play the antagonist hard. So I went in really hard playing Crixus as the antagonist. And everyone was like, oh, we hate him. Hope he dies. You know, da 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 da. But to be able to turn people's feelings around, like my feelings were turned around for this friend of mine in the hospital, my enemy who became my friend, to be able to do that to people, to have them hating somebody and to have them turn around completely. And potentially cry when I died. You know, I've met men who say they cried in that scene, but they say they hated me in the beginning. And to be able to win people's emotions over like that, I think opens up possibilities, you know. And whenever I'm playing a villain-esque kind of character, you know, like Slade Wilson as well, you know, I always try to infuse vulnerability, you know, suppressed emotions, you know, even when it's when the other characters aren't looking, you just have this moment where you go deep inside of yourself and just sit in that pocket. And I know what that pocket is, you know, I've had loss in my life, so I know the feeling, you know. Funny thing is, I have a lot of people from things like, you know, I have military people from like, who've been in Afghanistan and have got PTSD, and they come up to me and they go, bro, you know, we watched Spartacus when we were up in fighting in the mountains, you know, isolated and lost several of our team, you know, in a firefight, and you know, but you know, we all would get around and watch Spartacus. Story keeps people bonded together, and Spartacus was this sort of story that they related to. And here I am standing in front of these real warriors, these real soldiers who are pouring their heart out to me, saying like, oh, we really connected with Crixus, you know. And I think to myself, how did I do that on a television show? But the thing is, as an artist, you know, I had my brother died in my hands, to be honest, you know, died in my hands. So I know that feeling, and I can put that in as an artist into my performance. You know, I reserve it for that. That's my safe place for it, you know. But, you know, I think it's important that as an artist, you kind of like, you have to know life, you know, you have to be honest, you have to be upfront, and as much as you can give, you know. And, you know, I try to do that with my characters, you know. And at the end of the day, you know, when I come to these conventions and stuff like that, you know, and I come face-to-face with the fans, I realize that that's what they kind of take in through that screen, you know. And one thing that's very interesting about all of that that I found out last year was I went to Greece, and I went to a place called Epidavros. And in Epidavros, they built the very first amphitheater. The people who built it were called the Asclepio. The Asclepio were a medicine people that made apothecary and stuff like that. So they were into making medicines, and they were well known throughout Europe, and they would travel a lot with their medicines and teaching about medicine. And they built an amphitheater. The first one that was ever built was built in Epidavros. And it was built because they believed that voice and storytelling was healing. When I heard that, I suddenly felt this huge relief that I wasn't just caught up in Hollywood. you know, that I actually had an ancient reason for being in the place that I am, you know, to you know, when that person with PTSD comes to me and I can say, yeah, brother, you know, my brother died in my hands as well. And in this art form, we made an emotional connect across the void through a television screen, you know, but it was healing, you know, and that's valuable to me, really valuable, you know, so, yeah.